Hello and welcome to the 35th edition of the Sharjah International Book Fair. Today, we have a very special guest amidst us, and he's none other than the renowned and beloved lyricist, poet and scriptwriter of the Indian cinema, Mr. Javed Akhtar.
I think it's more semantic than real meaning. You know, obviously, you can only give what you have received. Ultimately, these are circumstances, the environment, your upbringing, different influences in your life, your own aspirations, fantasies, all of them together, your morality, together produce your writing. So in a way, I believe all the writing to some level, fiction, is autobiographical also. Even if you are writing a story of a prince and a fairy, the prince will have the morality or aesthetics that is your morality or aesthetics. Or what you think is not right. But your likes or dislikes will be the part of any story. And your likes and dislikes are the offshoots of your morality, and your morality is based on your circumstances, your upbringing, your environment, and so on. So, I suppose that ultimately, whatever you have received in life gets melted in your mind, in your conscious mind, in your subconscious mind, unconscious mind, and that defines you. That is you. But ultimately, once you have written, I suppose you also develop slowly some kind of understanding that this is my persona, this is my style of writing. So, consciously or unconsciously, that writing also starts governing you, what you have done and what you would like to do and what you think you do better. So, so it is ultimately at some stage it becomes mutual. Your writing becomes your partner. Writer and the writing become partners, and together they work. You know, it is such a pleasant surprise that I am seeing young people, and overwhelmingly the audience, say in Jaipur, in Kolkata, in Bangalore, wherever I have gone for these festivals, literature festivals. The overwhelming audience is a young person. And they are not there just for fun. I mean, they sit through sessions where very serious things are discussed in a very serious manner and in depth. And they listen with total attention. And one can see that they're interested and they're curious. That's wonderful. I have noticed that in younger generation there is a lot of interest in poetry. I go to many colleges and educational institutions and interact with a lot of students and young people. They are passionate about poetry. Yeah. But unfortunately, they have not been taught the craft. And that is where they make mistakes. A lot of them are cross-up poets, boys, girls. But I'm afraid that they need to learn the craft, most of them. And they can learn the craft of poetry by reading more poetry. So this is what I always advise young people, that before writing you must read a lot and by heart poetry. Because when you remember it and you can recite it by heart, then gradually you understand the rhythm. The meter, their discipline, how words are put together, how they fit with each other, and so on. That sensibility develops when you read poetry and remember it. See, Urdu is the language of people and has always been the language of people in North India. So, patronage or no patronage? It has survived. And even today, people love Urdu. People who, whose mother tongue is not Urdu, they also love Urdu, and they have great respect for the language, for its aesthetics, for its beauty, for its finesse, for its fineness. But unfortunately, they can't, they are not familiar with the script. So when they get the same poetry, Urdu poetry or Urdu literature, in a script that they can understand, which is more often than not the Devanagari, they buy the book, they read it, and you can ask any publisher in India that how much Urdu poetry and Urdu literature is sold in Devanagari. So maybe people are, as far as the script is concerned, less and less people are familiar with it, with every year. You know, because at most of the places it is not available in the schools and colleges. So they don't know the script. But more and more people are interested in Urdu and they read Urdu in India in Devanagari script. Oh, as a matter of fact, there are some very, very good young poets in India. I'm afraid I won't be able to take any particular name because in the poetry recitals I hear them, and these young poets are writing a very different kind of poetry. And their ghazal and their poetry has so much of freshness in it, there's no end to it. Like recently I heard a couplet from a young poet that, ये तो अच्छा किया तन्हाई की आदत रखी ये तो अच्छा किया तन्हाई की आदत रखी तब उसे छोड़ दिया होता तो अब क्या करते हैं? बहुत अच्छी they write beautiful. Now if they feel like writing prose, they should. Why not? I mean, this is not a kind of a demotion that, oh, he has started writing prose. It's totally up to an individual, whatever he or she wants to do.
And that was Mr. Javed Akhtar for you, with his abundant knowledge of literature and love for poetry. With camera persons Chetna Vaidyanathan and Shreyak Bopanna, this is Lubna Pathan for Manipal Dubai TV.